here we are with the big one.
The disappointment is written all over Dr. Janice Fitzgerald's face. This is the exact scenario the province's chief medical officer of health had been warning about.
I believe that going so long with low case counts of COVID led to complacency.
The outbreak originated in this high school. Fitzgerald says transmission spread through schools and sports teams and then to households. Many people with symptoms put off being tested.
It's very tense. People are really worried about what's happening in the community.
Traffic clogged the city's main streets as people scrambled to get tested. Hundreds are under quarantine. All the K-12 schools in the region are shut for 2 weeks to contain the spread.
We recognize, some of the fear and a little bit of the anger that's going around. And what we're asking people to do is just do what the health officials advise.
Politicians have suspended their door-to-door campaigns for Saturday's election. Progressive Conservative candidate Damien Follett's teenage son has tested positive for COVID-19. He doesn't know where his son contracted the virus.
We've all get too close to someone sometimes. It happens to me. Sometimes you forget.
The chief electoral officer says the election can proceed safely. Fitzgerald expects many more positive cases.
I don't expect that tomorrow will be lower than today.
In a tweet, opposition leader Chess Crosby said, "I am calling on the Premier and the Chief Electoral Officer to find a way to delay Election Day." The Liberal leader is defending the call.
Look, we made the election call with the best evidence available to us at the time. I don't believe altering legislation for political gain is an important instrument of democracy.
Public health officials are urging people to follow the rules to prevent the virus from spreading to other parts of the province. Chris O'Neill Yates, CBC News, St. John's.